So in the first section of this series, you learn about network security. The second aspect of Secure with Azure SQL is identity and access management. So far, when you've seen some demonstrations from Anna, you've seen her go into the portal, deploy an Azure SQL database, and even set up network security. What you might not have noticed is the fact that she had access to Azure. How would you get access to deploy an Azure SQL database before you even get security to log into SQL Server? So just like maybe in your data center where you've got certain policies set up or access controls through operating system methods, there has to be a way to give people permission to do various things in the Azure ecosystem. And we call that Azure Role-Based Access Control, or RBAC. So all Azure operations that you're doing to deploy various resources are going to use RBAC. And it's a system based on specific permissions from subscriptions, people that have subscriptions, based on various roles. So for example, you have an owner of a subscription or something called a contributor. Like in this particular case, Anna was probably a contributor who had access and was given permission to deploy Azure resources like Azure SQL. So Azure RBAC is separable from the SQL security system that you would give authentication rights to log into a SQL server, but it's going to give you all those rights and accesses to control and manage Azure resources in kind of a separation of duties concepts from deploying and managing Azure resources to the SQL Server security system itself. You can use the Azure portal or CLI to go through and use RBAC type policies and systems. Now, what we've done for you, instead of you creating specific roles for Azure SQL access, we actually have some built-in roles. You could be a SQL database contributor, which is going to give you specific rights to deploy Azure SQL database, or even a managed instance contributor to deploy managed instance. We even have a SQL security manager role where you do not have access to deploy things in Azure for Azure SQL, but you have certain rights to audit access to things going on in the Azure ecosystem for Azure SQL. So once you get past that, you get the traditional process and capabilities you need to learn about authorization to do authentication into Azure SQL. And this is going to feel very familiar to you and feel very similar to SQL Server. The very first thing you need to think of is mixed mode authentication. We talked a little bit about this in the earlier module. You know, remember, in SQL Server, you have two types of modes. You have Windows authentication or integrated security and SQL authentication. Because of the fact that we require a SQL Server login as an admin, and in fact, when you deploy, you get what's called a server admin as that SQL authentication, both for the logical server or for managed instance. And so mixed mode is forced. It has to be. And in fact, this server admin that's SQL is going to be a server level principal for your logical server in Azure database, and it's going to be a member of the sysadmin role for managed instance. Now, you're saying to yourself, that's interesting, but I need Windows authentication. I need that integrated security authentication. And so we supply and allow you to do Azure Active Directory authentication for administrators and for logins. So this is what it looks like for managed instance. For managed instance, in addition to that SQL login that's a sysadmin, you can create an Azure Active Directory server admin as well, and that becomes a member of the sysadmin role. You, in addition, can create logins just like you're used to today with SQL Server for SQL logins, or Azure Active Directory logins just like you would for Windows logins. You then can go through the process of creating database users that are mapped to these logins. And we even support the concept, like in SQL Server, of a SQL Server-contained database system. Now, what does this look like for Azure SQL Database? Well, very similar to MI, you can create an Azure Active Directory server admin that'll be just like that SQL admin you created in the beginning when you deployed Azure SQL Database. You also can create SQL logins, but this is where it kind of diverges a little bit. We have special server admin roles in the logical server that are going to allow certain logins to manage logins or to manage databases across your logical server. Now, you could create database users mapped to these logins as well in Azure Database, but here's what we recommend. We have the concept of contained database users without creating a contained database, and they could even be Azure Active Directory users. So think about this scenario here. You got capabilities for authentication just like you do in SQL Server, but what you're going to end up using is Azure Active Directory as that integrated type mode. Now that you've seen what the capabilities look like for authentication, what do you do? So remember, when you deploy, you're going to choose your SQL Server admin. But after you deploy, you could actually add an Azure Active Directory admin, both for MI or Azure Database. And then just like with SQL Server, what do you do? Well, admins that you've authenticated can now create other users or other logins, And then once you're done with that process, you grant access to SQL Server within this system, just like you would a SQL Server, whether that's using roles, whether that's granting specific authentication to objects, to logins, or to users. So think about what we've talked about in the concept of identity and access management. You need Azure RBAC to first, it's kind of chicken the egg concept, right? You need Azure RBAC to get rights to do things with Azure. Once you've got that down and deployed resources, then you're going to use SQL Server authentication methods that are slightly different in some cases with MIN database, including Azure Active Directory authentication. And then it's going to feel just like a SQL Server. You're just going to grant that access to the objects you need based on roles or based on logins that you've created or based on database users. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.